President Duterte's lead communication arm admits it will give advantage to him if he runs for vice president next year. The Presidential Communications Operations Office, or PCOO, says it will continue its coverage of Duterte even amid his possible election bid. The PCOO admitted this during a House hearing on his proposed budget for 2022.
I believe this is the first time that a president is running for vice president. But we have a mandate also, Mr. Chairman, to cover the president. I guess that is the equity of the incumbent.
Malinaw yan, no? Na ang buong makinarya ng PCO ay gagamitin to the advantage of the president.
President Duterte is expected to lead a convention hosted by a faction of his political party in San Fernando, Pampanga today. Aside from swearing in new members, the PDP Laban wing headed by Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi is also expected to reveal its candidates for the 2022 elections. The faction earlier nominated Duterte for vice president and his former aide Senator Bongo as its standard bearer. But the rival PDP Laban faction headed by Senators Manny Pacquiao and Coco Pimentel is confident today's convention will be rejected by majority of the party.
Ito ay tinuturing natin na illegal, unlawful, hindi naayon sa saligang batas at sa pool na hindi kinikilala ng pamunuan ng Partido Demokratiko Pilipino, Lakas ng Bayan. Kung tutuusin, batay sa assessment ng kasapian, tinatayang may 100,000 kasapian ang PDP Laban sa buong Pilipinas. Mga 80% no? Ng ating kasapian ay sumusuporta sa liderato ni Senator Pacquiao.
The PDP Laban faction led by Philippine Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi asks the Commission on Elections to declare as illegal all actions and representations of Senators Manny Pacquiao and Coco Pimentel. Pacquiao leads the rival faction that's backed by Pimentel, the son of the party's main founder. Pacquiao remains unfazed by the Cusi faction's move.
Hindi namin pinapakinggan yan dahil hindi naman sila legit na PDP at kami ang may hawak ng lahat ng data, ng complete data ng PDP. Yung data kasi nahawak namin ay yun yung mga talagang legit members ng partido. Kasi umabot ng 200 yung inorganize niya na nag-attend sa kanya. Alalahin ang partido, mahigit 100,000 ang member dito.
The Okta Research Group asserts its independence as it looks forward to doing public opinion polling. Okta Research made a name for itself with its COVID-19 data and projections during the pandemic, but the group wants to do surveys similar to those done by social weather stations and Polls Asia as the elections near.
Tugon ng mga sa nationwide surveys are non-commissioned. Okay, we do have subscribers who pay for rider questions, but we are not affiliated with any political party. Okay, and neither is any politician funding our group. It's very clear. Now we're a non-stock, non-profit company. We want to be as autonomous and as independent as we can, and that is why we're not open to being basically commandeered, no. Or bought by or controlled by one politician or one political party. That is not Okta Research.
Philippine House lawmakers are currently investigating the group to know more about the accuracy of its COVID-19 projections and its source of funding.